Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I am going to do a gorgeous set of nails that's inspired by somebody else. Who is it? Keep watching and I'll show you. So there's a post, I think it's on my Facebook. I've got a few different Facebooks. I've got Kirsty Meekin Nail Artist, I've got Kirsty Meekin Nail Nails, and I've got my own private one, which is Kirsty Avita Meekin.
That's not going to be private. Now everyone's going to start getting friend requests.
I've got loads of friend requests. I can't answer them all. So don't be disappointed. Go onto my pages and my groups. And somebody put on there, what nails would you want Kirsty to film? And then loads of people put loads of different pictures. This set come up and I was like, ooh, I like them. I could see me wearing them. I thought it was quite cool. So we're going to recreate them. So these are the nails. I think they are pretty fantabulous. These are by Vina Nails Houston. I think they are delish. Especially like the Sharpie bits and the transparent sections. Now when you look at this, I'm thinking, how's she done this? I've got to work it all out. There's two different ways she could have created the transparent sort of grey. You can do that with gel polish and you can also do it with acrylic. So I'm going to show you both ways. I am not going to do them exactly the same, but I'm going to use those techniques and skills to create a similar set. I would never want to just completely do like a carbon copy of somebody's work, but I'm very inspired by it. I think they're beautiful and we're going to do it. So I'm going to work on the three fingers all at the same time as if we are creating a full set. So I'm going to wipe over Annette's nails with some of the gel residue wipe off solution just to clean those up. I have already prepped them, so I've removed the surface shine, I've done cuticle work. And we're ready to sculpt these out. Those of you might know, Annette is our Olympic gymnast.
I was going to ask, how did you get on in was it the semi-finals? With the other
Commonwealth.
On? Commonwealth, yeah, that was it.
Oh, it was a first, gold and everything.
So the nails didn't hinder you?
Not in the slightest,
and
no.
You've got back from Australia quite quickly.
Wow. I'm also a superhero in spare time.
That's where the outfits are inspired from, then. Because gymnasts and superhero outfits are quite similar, I think.
Yeah, there's not much changing involved.
So we're going to do an almond-shaped nail. So on the picture, they are different shape, aren't they? Let me look here. So they're more of a ballerina-shaped nail. So we're going to do them a little bit different again. I have to cut that form. So if you see this nail, got quite a gap there, so I'm going to cut these corners out here. What we're going to do to get this transparent black, like it's like a sheer black, isn't it? Like a pair of sheer tights, I suppose, like a grey black. What we're going to do is we're going to add pure black acrylic. Then we're going to add clear. Now, don't ask me how many grams or, you know, per thing. I have no idea. It's all a guessing game. I'm going to mix it up. And then I'm going to test it. I think it needs some more clearing. That's my guess. I feel like I'm a magician now doing a magic trick. Yeah, I think it needs a little bit more clear. I just think it's a little bit dark. We are going to do a thin layer of this as well. So, a little bit more clear. Yeah, I think we're good to go. So I'm going to dehydrate with the nail prep dehydrator. And then we are going to use the acid-free primer. two thin coats. I've got medium speed in my dampen dish. People keep asking me, where did you get your dampen dish? I got this dampen dish from a little gift shop in Eidenhoven.
Eidenhoven.
Eindhoven. Eindhoven. What? I say it.
I thought it was Eindhoven.
Eindhoven.
I'm not sure.
Eidenhoven.
I'm not sure. You're making a question me geography lessons.
You know
now.
What? Is it the Netherlands?
Yeah.
Yeah, in the Netherlands. So, good luck finding that.
I might be wrong. I'm just.
Is it
Eindhoven?
Is there a D in it?
Yeah, there is a D.
Eindhoven. Eindhoven. Not Eidenhoven.
Yeah, Eindhoven.
Eindhoven. That's right.
E-I-N.
Little gift shop.
D.
Now, there's many, many bicycles there. Many, many, many bicycles. So you're going to do a nice thin layer of this colour. And this is going to be that transparent sheer black. Starting at the free edge first, we're making the connection between the nail and the form with the acrylic. Stop trying to look at it, Annette. She's been one of them clients, you know them clients that go, they want to look at the nails while you're doing the nails, which is like absolutely impossible. Next bead, straight onto that nail. Please excuse the dripping sound that you can all hear.
It's not even dripping.
It's not dripping. It's some card slowly falling down the wall. So we've got the transparent black on, and now we're going to cap this in clear. And I make sure, oh my God, that's not clear. That's blank slate.
I don't know how you could tell the difference then.
It was a bit milky.
But that looks milky.
Oh no, it was milky and milky. It was more like fresh from the cow milky.
In her spare time, that's what Kirsty does, milks cows.
Well, I suppose I do. I'm going to do this on this finger as well. So by the time I've laid this base colour down, this transparent black, I will be able to go back to the index finger and pinch it. So you've got to be mindful of that when you're working. So I'm going to come to this nail and pinch. That one can be pinching while I cap this one in clear. So I'll pinch the end of this as well, because the pinching tool will not go all the way to the end. See? Take that off. Does it feel like taking a pair of socks off at the end of the day when I take the form off?
Oh, definitely.
This one we're going to do completely black. So we're going to get the pure black acrylic powder, and Annette's going to knock it over. You probably can't quite see it, but there's a mound of black now.
Oh, wow, yeah.
Right, before I clean that up, I better come back to this one because it's going to have set by the time I've... So we're going to use pure black. I do want to lay down a very thin layer of structure. So what I'm going to do is use this transparent mix that we've done for my base. So a very, very, very thin base. I'm doing this because it will help to prevent lifting. And now the adhesion will be a lot better because this has got so much clear powder in it. Now I can go on with the pure black. This is super, super, super pigmented.
Looks like a Vanta black.
What do you mean?
That's that blackest material in the world.
Oh yeah, I remember I was looking at that one time.
Yeah, but were you?
Wow. Ooh. Was I just looking into a black hole?
Exactly.
Is it expensive, that stuff? I would imagine. I would imagine it is, isn't it? I'm just going to make sure this is nice and neat, because at the minute I'm not too happy with it. So I'm getting a bead that's small and a little bit wet, just to creep up to that cuticle. I'm still tipping the finger down to prevent any flooding. And I'm going to use the sheer black to cap it with, because I know it's got lots of clear in and I don't want to waste that pot and have it sat there. So I may as well utilise it throughout the full set. You could use just clear, you know, it wouldn't really make much of a difference. Now this one's set, we can take the foam off this one. And I can start filing these while this one starts to set up enough for me to pinch. So I'm going to go through my normal filing routine where I do the side walls first, then I'll go round the cuticle, make that nice and flush. I'll do the free edge shape and then contour the top surface. So we're going to use now, what we're going to use is Snow White. Right, so when we're going to do this one that's coming straight down the nail, obviously this brush is far too big to be doing that with. So I'm going to get some of the white Urban Graffiti Snow White gel polish onto a sculpting paper. So this is the paper from a sculpting form. And I'm going to go from top to bottom. That's our guide. And now we're going to make it wider. Very gently, small movements. And we're going to come down. Take a back now, y'all. I'm resting my fingers. This is the movement I'm doing. It's very small, and I'm only moving those three fingers to get that straight line. Yeah. I'm going to pop that into the lamp. I'm going to do a second layer of this. I'm going directly over the top. And pop that into the lamp. Into the lamp we go. When I do this one, because I'm going to do like a sweeping shape, I can simply use the brush from the bottom and go straight on to the nail. I'm just going to curl it round like this. And I can pop that in the lamp. Right, with those, the next step is to wipe over with the gel residue wipe off solution to take off the sticky layer from the white gel polish. Now, whenever we've done Sharpie designs before, I would normally need to top coat on top of the white, because when I put the Sharpies on there, it stains the white gel polish if there isn't a top coat on there. However, for this design, we actually want that to happen. So here are my Hobbycraft Sharpies. They can be any permanent marker. They don't have to be branded in a Sharpie. You know, other products are available. So I'm going to randomly put my colours on.
So how did you figure out that this was done with Sharpie?
Well, I might be wrong.
Oh.
Might not be done with a Sharpie.
Did you hear that, Kirsty? You said she might be wrong.
I'm not saying that this is the correct way, but this is how I would do that design.
So you looked at that design and you thought, right, okay, I could do it with this or I could do it with this, but I think
yeah,
it's the way
you
could
do it. Right. Yeah, you could do it with gel polish, in all fairness. But I'd like things to be quite quick as well. I've got some... Yeah, I was just checking what that was. I swear, I was thinking, I have put gel residue wipe off solution in that pot, haven't I? I didn't put, like, medium speed liquid. What I'm going to do now is just tap on there with my wet brush, let it sort of bleed. Make sure you don't let any of that Sharpie seep onto the black. So you can see how it gives it that tie-dyed effect straight away. And what I'm going to do now is touch again to give it that mottled effect. So the brush is slightly dampened, it's not saturated like this. You know, I actually dab off on some tissue very quickly a little bit of the gel residue wipe off solution. I love that. I love it. I want these nails. Every single set of nails I've done this week, I've wanted them. I am so disappointed that I have these nails on. I want new nails. So when you're ready, Adam.
Apparently you're 2 million subscribers.
When we get 2 million subscribers, you're doing them.
God.
And you've got to do them, like, amazing, obviously.
Well, obviously.
And I'm sure they will be. Because we haven't top coated it, you can see it goes quite matte as well. And the design that we've used as inspiration is also a matte design. It's actually all matte. However, I'm going to do it shiny. So we're going to have a gloss finish to this. Now, if you want them slightly lighter, you would then go again with your gel residue wipe off solution. But I quite like them that bright. Now, the next thing is we need some black acrylic paint. We need some water. I'm going to add a little bit of water to it so it flows nicely. I'm not making a wash, so it's not really watery, but it flows nice. And the first thing I'm going to do is outline my shape. I need Annette to stay super steady.
Just like you do when you land.
I've been on the bar.
That beam what?
On the bar. On the high beam.
So do you know Lewis Smith? Because he's an Olympian, isn't he?
Don't mention any Olympians, because I haven't got a clue. Mm. I don't watch the Olympics.
Yes, just associate with them.
No. Far superior.
Oh, so you don't, you just go and do your job and come home.
Exactly.
You don't go on the lash with Lewis Smith. I'd be going on the lash with him, let me tell you. Who is the most famous person that you've met?
I don't know any Olympians.
Just make it up. Play the game, Annette.
Make it up.
The Queen. The Queen!
I was going to be OBE.
Yeah. Right, so I've edged that and now I'm going to edge the whole nail. So I'm going to add this paint around the edge so it's like a frame. So I'm going to do the same with this one. I'm going to edge this and give it a frame. What that does, it makes it pop out more. You could do this with black gel polish as well. You know, this, that would be an alternative to the paint. Right, what we're going to do now is seal this with the Urban Graffiti top coat. I've got to make sure I go directly on top of all of that paint, capping it in. At that point, if you want a matte, you wouldn't put the Urban Graffiti top coat on. You would put on the Urban Graffiti matte top coat. Right, so what I'm going to do now is add some bling on here. We're going to use some of the metal pieces as well. I'm not going to put gold into it. I'm going to put silver into it. I prefer the silver. And I'm just going to use brush on glue to put these on. The stones anyway, I'll use the mega gloss to put on the metallic pieces. I'm going to finish off by putting some cuticle oil on. Just rub this all around. Take off the excess oil off the actual nail. So that's how I did the thumb. I This was a little finger. So on the little finger, I did a few different lines over the top of the Sharpie section as well. I like them. I like how you can see through the nail. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. We will link the Facebook and Instagram below. And we will also link Vina's Instagram so you can check her out too. So thanks for the inspiration. See you next time. Bye.
Ah, now I know what's knocking. It's your bloody... this.
Oh.
It's that. It's not even hitting the it's not even hitting the microphone, it's just hitting the side of the thing.
Sorry. You need torch of wardrobe.
Can you leave it dead loud then in your
yeah.
You'll have torch of wardrobe, sorry.
Oh, I tell you what, you ever wear that top ever again.
Is it driving you nuts? There. He's loving the tassels, Adam is, for the sound. Which is where Kirsty Mickey.
The ever elusive black poly colour.
It just goes missing all the time.
It's because it's black. It blends in.